still ain't got no. Hey, you still ain't got no haircut, man? Oh, man.
All right, well, let's change that then.
You still ain't got no haircut. Go to the next clip.
What's good, everybody? Birchpreneur back here with another video. In this video, I'm going to show you guys two things. How much I can make today, obviously. And then I'm going to give you guys one good pointer that helps save my on-time rating. Now, if you're somebody like me that has a lot of trouble with being on time and things, and believe me, I'm almost late to everything. Almost everything. Pretty much everything. And it's not that I don't care about things. It's just a deeply embedded habit that I have. But I figured out this little hack on DoorDash that helps me keep my on-time score higher than it normally would have been if I didn't figure out this hack. Hold on, I gotta call the customer because they don't ever wanna leave a gate code. All right, I gotta get another order too to show you guys how to do this. So cue the transition. I said cue the transition, bro. What you doing? All right, you know what? No transition. Just roll the next clip, man. Damn. So how you find this hack is when you swipe to arrival when you get to a restaurant, all you're going to do is you're going to click on the gray box that asks you what's taking so long or what's causing you to wait. It gives you a couple different boxes of reasons to choose from, or you can give them a specific reason that pertains to your situation. Once you're done doing that, then you're good to go. It doesn't matter how much longer you wait. It doesn't matter. Nothing matters after that because it's out of your hands. You're going to be waiting. So what this does in the algorithm, it basically tells DoorDash that, hey, sometimes when we offer this order, the food's not ready yet. So now we have to offer orders later on. But it's kind of counterintuitive because sometimes you're going to get to places early and they already have it ready. Or you get there early and they make you wait a good 30 minutes. We've all been there, DoorDash drivers, Postmates, Uber Eats. We've all been there. But I would say out of all the three, Uber Eats probably times it the best. And Postmates probably times it the worst. DoorDash is somewhere in between. So, you know, I guess this is supposed to help them, but really it's supposed to help you.
Also, some exciting news. The largest dash I've ever done, $104.25, baby.
Today, my goal is to hit $400. I was at $180 yesterday. And then, So I got to hit $400. Should be easy enough. Whatever. Let's get it done. So this has been my largest and longest dash ever. $211. I will show you the phone, but my camera's not focusing on it. So I'm going to just show you guys a screenshot. So, yeah, man, this has been Birchpreneur with you, giving you a little hack and also showing you how much I made today. This is how you make money during quarantine. Get it how you live it, baby. Can't be no bitch that only got Tyler Perry famous. Birchpreneur, out of here.